Junior, everybody! Charlie, one more time, saying all the shit I've been drinking. You guys ready for your headliner?
She is fucking amazing.
You may have heard her on her super popular podcast, The Hospice Trap House. Give it up for the one, the only, Kristy Belich!
Camel Toe. doesn't have an answer for that shit. We would go like fucking Wally the Walrus there with that fucking, do you ever, where, sir, are you off shift right now? Oh, you're looking, the thing is, this is the guy that's online and his name is QAnon. And then there's just a frog emoji next to his name. And then he comments below, women don't deserve to have any love. You know, you're the guy that goes on YouTube that tells women they're not funny. Like, you're that motherfucker. I'm glad that we got to meet face to face. Because here's the thing, I've been knowing you for years. Oh, now you're watching me like you're a fucking intel. You're the intel for the NSA right now with your fucking eyes. Okay. Go back to your seat. I don't want to have any time for you. Unless you want to crawl back. He looks like one of those guys that lives in one of those caves that you drive past on the 10 that have all the graffiti. That's what lives there. He's coming back now. Now he's looking, coming back with walrus sounds. Thank you. Go back to your Rudolph home, the red-nosed reindeer. Jesus Lord, do you see? Like, he didn't do that to anybody else, but he was like, I want to see your camel tail. And you know what the sad part is? Anybody watch Disney movies? Like, Disney movie fans? Like, all those Disney movies taught women, like, that codependency is what relationships should be about. And motherfuckers remind me of how the most influential Disney movie of all time is nothing to do with princesses or love. It's actually Mary fucking Poppins. And if you think about it, Mary Poppins was a hire a hoe. Like, that's what she was. She was a hire a hoe to take care of kids. And really, she was the first suburban drug pusher of her time. Right? Like, what do you do with white kids with no mom? You fucking give them drugs. Think about it. It's in the songs. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the heroin go down. The heroin go down. Yes, the heroin go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the heroin go down. Sponsored by the CIA. Yes, supercalifragilistic, snorting up your noses. That bitch brought us Adderall. And you know what that cunt in the back, Wally the Walrus, brought us? He bought us a fucking methamphetamine fucking fentanyl trips. That's what he fucking brought us. You're like, who's human trafficking? That motherfucker. Doesn't he look like one of those guys that has like a stick? Like, you know those truckers? Do you ever see like psalms on the back of a truck? It's just like, we love Jesus in the name of Jesus. He's the guy with the Jesus quote on the back of the truck. It's interesting because I do have a Jesus sticker on the back of my car, but it has nothing to do with anything related to loving Jesus. It's just to keep motherfuckers off my ass when I'm driving, and if they fucking cut me off, they get suck my clit if you want to cut me off on the fucking 10. Anybody have dirty jobs here other than Wally? Right. I grew up doing a lot of dirty jobs. I came from a military family, two military nurses, and I had to take my sport of choice as a youngster was equestrian jumping, which is the whitest rich bitch sport of all time. You know, it was so many white rich cunts all the time, and like, I'm from the East Coast, so like, I was riding horses literally against football teams, owners, grandkids, and like fucking politicians' kids. And I was like, I'm gonna fucking kick these assholes. Like, I'm gonna go over these fences like nobody's ever seen this before. But in order to afford my sport, I don't know if you guys know this here at the Hobnob Sports Bar in Chandler, Arizona, but horse cocks are retractable. And they have to be cleaned a very specific way, you know? It's called sheep cleaning for my connoisseurs here. And basically, to everybody talking over there, I don't know if you guys know this, but in order to clean a participants here. And ultimately, because horses are also circumcised, you want to go, and there were Jewish jokes earlier, so because horses are uncircumcised, you actually want to go up into the uncircumcised portion. I'll do a 4-H County Fair. So like pretend this is a horse cock, like an uncircumcised cock. I'll talk to the guy in the front. He'll report on this. So you see this finger here, right? So you want to take this finger and go into the uncircumcised cock, and you want to curve it. And for my heterosexuals here, this is how you get to the G-spot, you assholes. Lesbians here, you fucking already know. And bisexuals, LGBTQ, whatever the fuck. So anyway, there's also, I don't know if you all know this too, but there's actually specialized cleaner for horse cocks. So the guys doing the anal sex in the front, it's like this, it's called Excalibur Sheath Cleaner. It's like this viscous green goo, and you kind of like go like that, you know, kind of jack it off a little bit, and then you want to pop out what's this, like this bean. It's called a bean, which is compact smegma. It kind of looks like a Jelly Belly jelly bean, you know? Maybe something else that would pop out of butt, I don't know, but I just want to let everybody here know that I might not have been the richest child, but I was so good at the age of 13 at cleaning horse cocks that is how I became the grand champion at the Howard County Fair. I'm no longer a comedian, I am a motivational motherfucking speaker, okay? Really great in a special skill, clean some cocks, do what you gotta do to make your shit work, you know? Alright. That joke went up and down, just like the emotions of this room. We're gonna follow that shit. Alright. I am an astrologer by day. I'm sure I already look like it with the fucking glasses and the poncho. But I will tell you, a lot of women ask me, like, what do I do, you know, during this economy? And I wish I could tell people, don't go to college. Just don't fucking go. Don't get yourself in that debt. Get yourself behind a paywall. It can be OnlyFans. It can be anything. But the goal is just to get your ass cheeks clapping. Like, that's it. Get some coconut oil and get those kids a house. You know what I mean? Like, that's all I can say because, I don't know, are you guys excited for the age of Aquarius? Anybody here? Does anybody know what the age of Aquarius is? The age of Aquarius? It's okay. Very close, sir. It's Mark Zuckerberg asking us all to enter the metaverse. That's what the age of Aquarius is. It's so weird. If we look at the future of reality, the metaverse or whatever virtual VR society that we're entering, we're all going to get locked in so hard that nobody's ever going to leave. And my whole question is, think about these beta cuck motherfuckers in their skinny jeans and their acorn-shaped balls. Most of them are online. Most of them are like, fuck women, they don't want me. Those are the guys that are gonna get so locked into this fucking virtual reality because anything goes. And that means that porn is gonna go insane. Like my whole question is, who the fuck's gonna walk their dogs at that point, you know? Because if you think about it, just imagine. This is me. My name's Mark. I'm a skinny white boy from Tulsa. And nobody ever wanted to fuck me. So what I did was I got myself some VR goggles while in the walrus. And then what happened is I got so stuck in the metaverse because I was jerking off so hard. And then what happened is my dog escaped and went out into the wilderness while I was jerking off to anything you could think of. Think about it. Megan Thee Stallion, but her ass is in 12D to the point that her fucking asshole be nubbing your cock. I'm gonna make this so uncomfortable for everybody here. You're gonna be nubbing your cock. And then what's gonna happen? Because this is biology now in the age of Aquarius. Is these guys are gonna slowly start filling with cum. Slowly fill with cum to the point that they look like a giant tick full of their own cum. Hobnob, do you guys know what's gonna happen next? What's gonna happen to these beta cups? They're going to explode from all of their cum. My friends, are you excited for the age of Aquarius? Because that is what's gonna happen. Because we are the last indigenous biologicals on this entire planet. And if you are one of those beta cup motherfuckers, just know you might be one stroke away from exploding and perpetuating an artificial intelligence species. I like that some of you are on board. I like that some of you are confused. I like that some of you still hate women. I'm talking to you. I like that some of you have half chub right now because you're not sure if I'm some kind of dominatrix that was sent here from another planet. I'm trying to get them. Why are you still standing there, Wally? Why are you still bringing up the camel toe? You, for one thing, the word is mesmerized. You said memorized, which is something you really need to do somewhere else. Go memorize the Constitution or something. I know that's what you guys like to do. Liberty Bell 488 on YouTube. Have you taken the red pill? Because you look like you have. You took the blue pill.
The blue pill.
You took we have a gay Wally lovers. If you are a gay bear right now, do not touch. That's my man, and I'm looking for a husband. And I don't care if him and I are gay. We'll have a civil marriage. Wally reminds me of the time that I was walking home from work. Do you feel accosted by the white man right there?
Die soon, we already know.
He's on his last legs. He's got 1 year left. If not, the witches will get him. We already know that. Alright. I'll leave with a bedtime story since I'm losing my damn voice. I was walking down the street coming home from work, and this guy in this blue Prius, alright? Society has changed, you know, blue Prius. Glides up next to me, slowly rolls his window down, and he says, "Excuse me, miss, I have a question for you." And I was like, "Bro, I'm good to go." So I see him pop a U-turn, go down the street, and then he pops another U-turn, glides up next to me, and he goes, "Excuse me, miss, I still have a question for you." And I was like, "Sir, I'm okay." He goes, "Can I please ask you, do you mind watching me jerk off? You don't have to suck me off. I can do that shit on my own." And the thing is, the fight or flight in me immediately kicked in. I was like, I need to get the fuck out of here. But the comic brain in me was like, I kind of need to see how he does that, you know? And also, like, clearly the guy in the Prius cares about the environment. Of course he knows how to suck his own cock in his car, you know? But then my brain was like, hey, he probably does like yoga, super bendy and flexible, all that shit, you know? But it got me thinking about guys like that, and also guys like Wally got me thinking, because I was in Texas when all the Roe v. Wade shit went down, and I was like, why don't guys like that
get aborted,
you know?
Oh, shit.
Because if we think about it, I've been driving this entire country as a comic. I've lived in my car. I've done all that shit as a comic. And all I see are Northwest, just all these billboards like, please don't toilet baby me, you know, they're like, God doesn't want you to toilet baby these babies, right? But I was thinking to myself, what kind of fucking parent, a neglectful parent, goes when the baby pops out the camel toe, hey, my baby's so beautiful that we need to get you into a casting office and we need to let everybody know, please do not abort babies, right? But my whole question is, what if you were that baby and you grew up to be the biggest fuck up of all time? And you're just like, hey, that was on my resume then, and everything fell off after the age of 5 months old, you know? And then you end up just being a meth head, and at that time, you're fucking, it's the kind of, like, you didn't have teeth then, you don't have teeth now, you know? All right, the abortion joke did not go well. But I feel like if I were going to bring us together as a class tonight, I would say we all can agree that Wally the Walrus should have been one of those aborted toilet babies.